I want to welcome everybody into today's game versus William Carey. We are Point University, and welcome to the Point Skyhawk Sports Network. Tonight's game for the Point Skyhawks, we have Cam Seiwert, our starting pitcher, number 22. This is Point Skyhawks' first conference game versus William Carey. William Carey's first conference game as well. Going to be getting started here pretty soon. In Point's previous game, we played Tuskegee University. Point University did take the win 7-2 versus them. Point University is on a one-game winning streak currently. Our opponents, now they're on a three-game winning streak as they took down Talladega College 2-1 in their previous game. Getting in the final few warm-up pitches for Cam before he faces his first batter, the first batter of the ballgame. There's the final warm-up pitch. As RJ Stinson will step up to bat for the first bat of the ballgame.
Up to bat for your Crusaders, number 12, RJ Stinson.
RJ Stinson steps up to bat. And here is your first pitch of the ballgame. Cam takes the sign. Here's the pitch. Taken for strike one. Good start here for the Point University Skyhawks. And the pitch. Swung on. Fouled left. Well, foul ahead of that pitch. It'd be an 0-2 count here to start off the game. Being aggressive here against RJ Stinson, probably a good idea since he walked three times. Here's the swing. Foul hits it towards the shortstop. He throws it to the first base, and he is out. Good start here for Point Skyhawks. Three pitches, one man down. A routine play for Sam. Quality shortstop.
Up to bat, number three, Jake Lissette.
Now up to bat for William Carey, Jake Lissette. The first baseman here for William Carey looking to get on base. First pitch, called strike. Cam Seiwert off to a great start here. Four pitches, four strikes. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Hit towards the second baseman. Routine play for him once again. Now that'll be two outs for the Skyhawks. Solid start here for the Skyhawks. Two quick outs. Love to see it with the ace on the mound. Keep the pitch count low. Here comes the catcher, Braden Coffey. Looking to get a two-out rally here for the William Carey. Steps up to the box. First pitch, first ball of the ball game. Be a 1-0 count.
Butler!
We are back here in the bottom of the first inning on the Skyhawk Sports Network. Up to bat is Silas Butler. The pitcher here for the William Carey Crusaders is Bobby McGee, number 23. His first pitch will be called a ball. Be the Skyhawks' first chance to swing the bats. Silas Butler takes the pitch, swings, and misses. 1-1. Bobby McGee is a right-handed pitcher. Second pitch. That'll be a called strike. 1-2 count. Strike three, called. Silas Butler gets caught looking. Be one out.
Off the bat for Scouts is number one, Kenny Jackson.
Kenny Jackson coming in to bat. His first attempt to swing the bat as he steps to the left-handed batter's box. First pitch, swung on, hit high, far. It will just be foul. It reaches past the fence and will be a foul ball. Just a few feet to the left, and that would have been Skyhawks' home run. Kenny Jackson tries to ambush him there on the first pitch. He'll swing up the second pitch as well. Hit in fair. First baseman dives for the plate, and he will get the out. A little bit of hesitation there from the first baseman as the pitcher tries to run over to first to cover.
Now batting your left fielder, number 8, Slade Meek.
Two quick outs here for the Skyhawks. Slade Meek steps up to bat. An interesting play there at first as the first baseman has to dive for the bag. You don't see that every day. He gets the batter out by about 2 steps, I'd say. Slade Meek takes ball 1. That'll be called strike. Bobby McGee here, pitching very quickly. Gets the ball back, takes the signal, and pitches. Strike 2, swinging there. Bobby McGee looking to be quick here. 2 quick outs, that's for sure. Another pitch swung on, foul tips. It'll remain a 1-2 count. The next pitch. Inside, swung on and foul tipped once again. Slade battling here. Another swing and another foul tip. That one hits the umpire. Seems to be okay. 3 straight foul balls. Slade trying to get our Point Skyhawks rally here with 2 outs. Stays. Takes it for a ball. Doesn't go all the way around. 2-2 count. 2s all the way across the board once again in this inning. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Swung on, hit towards the shortstop. Throws it over to first. Gets it there in time. That'll be 3 outs for the Skyhawks. And we'll be back here for more in the Skyhawk Sports Network. We are back here in the top of the second inning for the Skyhawk Sport Network. Stepping up the bats should be Brady Wilson. First pitch is swung on, caught by the second baseman. Does a good job being aggressive there, catching it in the air. Catches it on one knee. Prevents it from dropping, having to throw it first. It's a good eye from the second baseman there. Billy Garrity steps in the bat. One pitch, one out so far here in this inning. That'll be called strike. Good pitch right there from Cam. Second pitch is swung on. Hit to the shortstop, Sam. Throws it over first. Routine play. Two outs here. One hit here so far for the William Carey Crusaders. The only ball to leave the infield.
Not bad. Number seven, Bradley Thomas.
The seven-hole hitter stepping into bat here, Bradley Thomas. Number seven has well on his jersey. Shows the bunt, pulls it back just in time for the called ball. Definitely left that bat out there pretty long. Second pitch. Swings at this one. Fouls it up behind the press box. Two strikes here. No, one strike. One and one count. Did pull that bat back in time. Cam with the pitch. Gets by the catcher. Nobody on base and nobody advances. Be a called ball. 2-1 count. Certainly a lot of quick outs here so far in this game. Foul tips once again behind this press box. It'll be a 2-2 count now. Two's across the board for the third straight half inning. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Cam gets the signal. Called strike three. Catches him looking. The batter is in disbelief. Certainly thought that pitch was outside, but it will be called a strike. And we'll be back here for more on the Skyhawk Sports Network. Stepping in is Alex Marquand. bottom of the second inning here. Skyhawks looking to get their first hit of the ball game. Bobby McGee back out there for the next pitch. Called ball. Righty-lefty matchup here as Alex swings the bat left-handed. Swings at that pitch. Grounds it through for a base hit. Pretty close to hitting the pitcher there, but he makes it in between the second baseman and the shortstop.
Up the bat, Pierce Goss, it's number 33. Zeb Baird!
Stepping in, Zeb Baird, trying to get something going here for the Skyhawks. Nobody out here. A good start from Alex. First time Bobby McGee is going to be pitching off the stretch. Zeb shows bunt. Ball's in the dirt. Pulls it away for ball one. No advance there from Alex Marquand. Bobby definitely slowing down here now. He's pitching out of the stretch. Looks over to first base. Comes out the plate. Swung on. His. Easy fly ball here for the center fielder. Good catch there from Jared Williams.
Off the bat, number 3, Mason Davis.
So Zeb goes down there quickly, and they'll leave it up to Mason Davis to try and bring in Alex Marquand from first base. First pitch, called strike. Umpire seems to be giving that outside edge just a little bit. Alex Marquand not with a big... Oh, throw to first. Just about to mention it, Alex Marquand not really stepping very far off first base, but he still gets the pickoff move. Designated hitter, Alex Marquand. Throws a pickoff move once again. Alex not even having to slide because he's really just not that far off the base. Bobby McGee maybe trying to get in the head. Maybe just trying to keep him on first base. Only taking about 2 steps off first base. Here's the pitch. This one's grounded into left field for a base hit. Alex Marquand will advance up to second. And Mason will be on safe at first. Whew. The throw back into the pitcher over his head. Nobody advances off of it, though.
Number 21, Jason Dower.
Third baseman Jason Dower stepping up to plate here. Looking to bring in the first runner in scoring position for the Point Skyhawks. Runners on first and second here. Here's Bobby McGee with a pitch. High pitch, called ball one. Looks like an early off-speed pitch there. Maybe didn't finish it quite like he wanted it to. Another off-speed pitch, high, well above the plate. Be ball two. Jason Dower here, certainly in a batter's count. Could go for a walk here to see if he can get the bases loaded. Might get the green light here from the coaches as well, try and bring in the first Skyhawk runner. Swung on, foul tipped well above the press box. Be a 2-1 count. Jason Dower here. Trying to get the Skyhawks on the board. Alex Marquand on second. Mason Davis on first. Bobby McGee with the pitch. Checking the runners multiple times. Another high pitch. Well above the plate. Jason Dower just looks at it. It'll be a 3-1 count here. Up the bat next is Sam Baker, certainly one of Skyhawks' best hitters. The pitch swung on, hit high into center field. Center fielder will call off the left fielder and will catch it. It'll be two outs here for the Skyhawks. No advancement from either runner. Jared Williams getting tested here early. Coach Tyler for the Skyhawks approaching the umpire. Looks like we might have a pinch hitter here for Sam Baker. Number six.
Jaden Mazzafaro.
Looks like we're not going to see Sam Baker here. Jaden steps into plate. He is a left-handed hitter. Might be a strategical decision. Oh, no. Yeah, I see it now. First pitch, call the ball. Jaden Mazzafaro is actually stepping in for the catcher, Easton Harrison, not Sam Baker. I'm mistaken on that. So catcher for catcher here. Second pitch. Called strike one. Runners still on first and second here. Now with two outs. Skyhawks looking to get a two-out rally here. Trying to put points on the board. Still a 0-0 score here between William Carey and Point University. Here's the pitch. Swung on. It will get through the shortstop. Rounding third is Alex Marquand. He will slide in safe. A two-out rally there. First run on the board scored by Alex Marquand, the pinch hitter. Jaden Mazzafaro.
Up the bat for your Skyhawks is number 11, Sam Baker.
Sam Baker steps in. And Easton will be back on to pinch run for Jaden. And now Easton's going to get subbed out as well. Number four, Hunter. Neumeier.
Number four, Hunter Neumeier.
So Easton was going to step in to pinch run for Jaden. Now Hunter Neumeier is going to be going in the pinch run at first base. On second, here's the first pitch to Sam. Shows bunt, pulls back, ball one. Runners on first and second here. Two outs. Skyhawks are on the board. 1-0 Point University. Sam will pull back. That'll be a called strike. Be a 1-1 count. The nine-hole hitter, Sam Baker, here. Swung on. Hit deep into left field. Left fielder backs up and catches the ball for the third out for William Carey. So Skyhawks do manage to score a run. It'll be 1-0 Point University. And we're going to take a break here on the Point Skyhawks Network.
Hernandez.
At the top of the third inning, that'd be Rigoberto Hernandez. Eight-hole hitter here playing second base. Cam Seiwert back on the mound for his third inning of pitching. His first pitch will be called a ball well outside. Second pitch swung on, foul tipped behind the plate. It'll be a 1-1 count. Cam Seiwert loses his hat on that throw. Maybe get some extra oomph in there. Called ball two. The Wheeling Crusaders are on a 3-game winning streak. Their previous game, they won 2-1. Looking to maybe extend that winning streak here against the Point Skyhawks. The next pitch, swung on, foul tipped once again. Be a 2-2 count. Cam takes the second signal as he didn't want the first pitch. Throws. Inside, ball three. Be a full count here. The Skyhawks will be facing the Crusaders once again tomorrow for a doubleheader at 1 and 4 o'clock. Next pitch, swung on, back up to the pitcher. Second baseman does get there, throws it first. First baseman does not catch it. A low throw there, hard to pick. And it'll be safe at first. Is Rigoberto. Went on, nobody out.
Up to bat, number
18, Jared Williams. Has some good defensive plays already in this game. Has just caught two fly balls out in center. CB strike one. Second pitch, swung on, does go around, tries to stop himself, but the home plate umpire calls him to go around. Be two strikes here, no balls. Cam Seiwert ahead of the pitcher here. Runner on first, Cam looks at him. Left-handed pitcher is Cam, so he can keep an eye on him. Strike three! Cam Seiwert with another strikeout here. Loses his hat once again. He's really trying to throw the ball as hard as he can, looks like. William Carey back up to the top of the order with their one-hole hitter, R.J. Stinson. Cam Seiwert faces nine batters through two and a third. Gives up one hit. First called ball. No runs so far for Cam. One out, one on. Second pitch, call the ball. Gets away from the catcher, but not too far. Runner will stay on first. Easton Harrison remains their catcher on defense after he gets pinch hit for and then pinch ran for. He will remain the catcher. Runner steals, and it'll be a hit and run. That ball will get past the third baseman. He will stay at second and third. It'll be runners on second and third as the left fielder is able to get to the ball before he rounds that third base to try and score. It'll be one out, three hits so far here for Cam, and runners on second and third. R.J. Stinson with a double.
Up to bat, number three, Jake Lissette.
Up to bat, Jake Lissette. A little hit and run there from William Carey Crusaders. Runner takes off from first. RJ Stinson does swing at the ball and makes it past the third baseman for a fair ball. Here is Jake Lissette up to bat. Only one out here with runners in second and third. Two runners in scoring position. First pitch to Jake Lissette will be a ball. The cars drive by honking at the game. Second pitch. Framed well there from Harrison. It'll be a 1-1 count. Gotta love it when a catcher can frame a pitch for your pitcher. There's the pitch. Swung on. The runner will score, but the second baseman collects it and throws it to first. It'll be a tie ball game here between your Point University Skyhawks and the Crusaders, as that sacrifice will earn himself a run. A routine play there by the second baseman, but can't throw it to the catcher in time, so he'll go to first, get the easy out, and sacrifice the run. The runner does advance from second to third, so there will be a runner at third base with two outs. Here's the pitch. Wow, he calls it in. He went around on that pitch for strike one. Up to bat here is Braden Coffey. Looking to give the Crusaders the lead here against the Point Skyhawks. Next pitch will be called a ball low. Well collected there by Easton. One count. Off-speed pitch there is called a ball. RJ Stinson's on third base, looking to be aggressive. That'll be swung on and through to the outfielder. It'll be a base hit, and the Crusaders will take a 2-1 lead over the Skyhawks. Braden Coffey there with a single. Up to bat now, Cam Trusclair, the DH. Grounded out in his first plate appearance. Now a man on first. Swung on, strike one. A bit of a half swing there. He doesn't go all the way around, but definitely went well past the base for a strike one. Braden Coffey looking to be a little bit aggressive lead there. The pickoff attempt will come with that aggressive lead, but he will be back safely. A pretty soft pickoff attempt. He's mostly just trying to keep him at the base. Did Cam. Now Cam with the pitch. Swung on. Strike two. The DH Cam Trusclair down early here in an 0-2 count with two outs. Trying to keep the Crusaders alive here in the top of the third inning. The pitch. Called strike three. And that'll be it. The Crusaders do take the lead, and it'll be the Point Skyhawks up to bat next. We are back here in the bottom of the third inning. Up to bat now, Silas Butler, as we reach the top of the batting order for the Point Skyhawks. First pitch is called a ball. Silas Butler reached base three times in his last game and scored three total times as well. Second pitch, called a strike, 1-1 count. Skyhawks beat Tuskegee University 7-2, with Silas responsible for three of those runs scored as he swings here for a called strike two. Be a 1-2 count. Silas Butler looking to get on the board once again here against the William Carey Crusaders. Strike three. Ball was in the dirt. Looks like they called the runner out on the strikeout.
Now batting first class is number one, Kenny Jackson.
Kenny Jackson now stepping up to the plate with one out. Shows bunt, pulls back, called strike. Left-handed batter here, so a quicker route to first base. Next pitch is called a ball. Bobby McGee back on the mound for his third inning of work. Certainly a fast pitcher. That pitch is high for a ball two. 2-1 count. A very noticeable difference between when Bobby's pitching out of the stretch and when he has no runners on, with the speed at which he pitches the ball. That next pitch will be called for ball three. What I mean by that is when there's nobody on base, he gets the ball, he takes the signal, and he pitches his next pitch. But with runners on base, he slows it down. Kenny Jackson there with a swing and a miss for a full count. Swings, misses, called strike three. Two strikeouts there for Bobby McGee.
Now batting is number eight, Slay Mink.
Slade Mink steps up to bat here. He joined Silas in the home run parade in his last game. Called strike one here. Two home runs hit by the Skyhawks in their last game against Tuskegee. This ball's hit over the first baseman who jumps and can't make the play. That ball will roll to the right fielder, and it'll be down for a base hit. Not the home run the Skyhawks were looking for, but they'll safely take a hit there. And Alex Marquand steps up to bat.
Up to bat, number 13, Alex Marquand.
Alex Marquand already with a hit in this game. Can he get a second here? Two outs here for the Skyhawks with a man on first. Much more of an aggressive lead here from Slade Mink. Bobby McGee throws off to first, and they get him over there. Slade Mink caught with a pickoff move there at first base. That'll be three outs for the Skyhawks. That aggressive lead may not have worked out for him right there. And we'll be back for the Skyhawks Sports Network. Entering the top of the fourth inning, William Carey leads the Skyhawks 2-1. Four hits apiece for both teams. Cam Seiwert back out to pitch once again for his fourth inning of work. His first pitch is called ball. Well outside the plate. Up to bat, Brady Wilson. Second pitch called ball as well. Be a 2-0 count with nobody out. Early in the top of the fourth. William Carey looking to extend their lead as the pitch comes. Swing on and miss. 2-1 count. Here's the pitch. Called ball three. Third baseman Brady Wilson will step into bat. Here's the pitch. Ball four. An early walk here for the Crusaders. In their previous game, the William Crusaders earned 8 total walks, which certainly contributed to their 2 runs and their win. I guess the Talladega. Ooh. Swung on, foul tips. It is over the fence. Unable to be caught by the right fielder. It'll be an 0-1 count here. Billy Garrity up to bat. The right fielder. 0-1 count. Man on first. Swung on here. This one's in play. Center fielder will come up and make the catch. Easy out there for the center fielder. As Billy Garrity will fly out.
Number 7, Brittany Thomas.
Bradley Thomas steps in. Still a man on first, now with one out. Pickoff move. Be safe over there at first. Trying to keep the batter. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Fair ball. Past the third baseman. Into left field. Runner past the second. Runner past the first. Not collected well there out in left field, but he does get it in time. And William Carey will have runners at second and third with only one out. The second hit in 2 straight innings past the third baseman into left field. And there will be runners at second and third once again. Rigoberto Hernandez stepping in. Looking to extend the lead for the Crusaders. Hits both times were just barely fair past the third base. That ball will get by the catcher. The runner runs home, and it will be safe. So Cam Seiwert there with a wild pitch. Catcher doesn't even get the glove on it. The runner does advance from second to third as well. And William Carey will extend their lead to 3-1. Ethan Harrison does appear to be upset that that ball got by him. Cam Seiwert's got to regain his composure here. Delivers the pitch. Called strike. Well done. Be a 1-1 count here. This came sideways. Looks to get back on track. Runner on third here. One out. Second pitch. Also called strike. 1-2 count. Strikeout would be huge for the Skyhawks. Prevent any sort of sacrifice fly opportunity for the Crusaders. There's the pitch. Swung on. Foul tipped behind the plate. Rigoberto Hernandez here with a 1-2 count with one out. That'll be a ball. This came aside where it licks the pitch to earn himself a strikeout. Here's the pitch. Called strike three. The batter will be caught looking. Gives his piece to the umpire as he walks back to the dugout. And there will be two outs here for the Skyhawks.
Now batting center fielder number 8, Gerard Williams.
The center fielder will step in for the William Carey Crusaders. First pitch is a strike. Bradley Thomas still remains at third. Looking to score. That ball deep inside will be called a ball. Narrowly misses hitting Jared Williams. For a 1-1 count. Very close to hitting the batter. That ball also inside. Jared Williams does swing, but doesn't go all the way across the plate. So it'll be called a ball. Next pitch here from Cam Seiwert. Will be swung on over the pitcher's head. The shortstop does collect it, throws it first, and gets the out. So the Skyhawks do give up a run as William Carey takes the lead 3-1. And we'll be right back here on the Skyhawk Sports Network. We are back in the bottom of the fourth inning. Stepping up to the plate is Alex Marquand. Got a chance to swing the bat in the last inning. Didn't get to complete his at-bat as the pickoff move was successful at first. So he'll reset his at-bat. Swings here. Fouls it off first base side. second pitch from Bobby McGee. Swung on, hit deep into center field. The center fielder will back up and make the catch. Third catch there from Gerard Williams. Zeb Baird here is stepping into the plate. Looking to get something going here for the Skyhawks. Bobby McGee once again back on the mound. Here's the pitch. Called ball. Bobby definitely wanted that pitch as he shakes his head. Second pitch here. This one's a called strike. Gets the ball back, takes the signal. Goes to the plate. Call ball. High pitch there. This next pitch will be a call to strike. It'll be a 2-2 count with one out here for Zeb. Swung. Put in play. Shortstop charges it. Bobbles it. Can't get it to first. Does a good job charging the ball there, but the shortstop cannot collect it. Puts it in his throwing hand so he can throw it to first. And Zeb Baird will reach first base.
Up the bat for your Skulls is number 3, Mason Davis.
Skyhawks catch a break there as the Crusaders commit their first error of the ball game. First pitch, called strike. Mason Davis in here to swing the bat. Swings it and misses for the second strike. Down early here in this at-bat. Zeb Baird takes his lead off first. Not an aggressive lead. Don't want to get caught. Mason Davis swings at that next pitch. It'll be a foul ball. Skyhawks certainly not looking to get caught at first base once again for the second time in this game. Not very aggressive leadoff there from Zeb. Next pitch. Call the ball. Don't want to give away any free outs, especially ones that they gave us a free base runner off of the error. Next pitch. Swung on. Center fielder stumbles, but he will make the catch.
Off the bat for your Skulls, third baseman, number 21, Jason Dower.
Gerard Williams performing well out there in center field as he catches his fourth ball as Jason Dower steps up to plate. Got a good read on that ball as he stumbles coming out of his break, but he manages to make the catch. There'll be two outs here with one on base. The pitch, called strike. Jason Dower here looking to put the Skyhawks back on the board. Swings and foul tips it into the glove for strike two. Down early here in this count. Next pitch, swung on for strike three. That'll be it for your Skyhawks here in the bottom of the fourth. And William Carey will be up to bat after this break from the Skyhawk Sports Network. Here we are at the top of the fifth inning. RJ Stinson back up to bat as we reset the batting order for the Crusaders. RJ Stinson will take ball one here. He was responsible for three of the walks, of the eight total walks for the Crusaders in the last game. Got on base three times via walk. Takes a strike there. Good pitch. Cam Seiwert back out for his fifth inning of work. Five hits given up. Three runs. No errors committed yet by the Skyhawks. Second pitch will be swung on. Foul tips. Cam looking to get back on track as he gave up runs in his previous two innings. Still pitching pretty well. Only a few strikeouts, but doing what he can to keep the Skyhawks in this game. One, two count. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Deep. Foul tip to the left. RJ Stinson looks to be in protective mode here as he swings the bat. Next pitch, swung on. This time it'll be put in play. The left fielder will stay, and it'll be down for a base hit. Slade Meek chooses to not charge that ball and let it fall and keep it from getting by him. Always a gamble whether you should charge the ball or not, but with nobody out, nobody on, you'll choose to take the safe option and keep the runner at first. Here's the pitch by the catcher, and RJ Stinson will get to second base. So the second wild pitch there from Cam Seiwert, as the runner will advance over to second. Jake Lissette, the first baseman, up to bat here, 1-0 count. Cam watching that runner at second. Jake Lissette shows butt, and it'll be a called strike. Maybe looking to advance that runner over to third via the bunt. Here's the pitch. Called strike. No bunt show there from Jake Lissette. Cam gets the signal, looks over to RJ Stinson at second, delivers the pitch, swung on, foul tipped, back behind the plate, rolls back all the way over to Cam, chooses to get a new ball. It'll remain a 1-2 count here. Cam taking his time in between pitches. Looks at this runner back. And he'll step off the mound here, forcing RJ to run all the way back to second base, but with nobody, no defenders there near the base, he won't bother to throw. RJ with an aggressive lead out there at second. This ball will get past the catcher once again as he tips it up, allowing the runner to advance to third. So two wild pitches here, and this at-bat alone allows the runner to get from first all the way to third. And it'll remain at 2-2 counts with nobody out here. Crusaders looking to extend their lead. Currently 3-1 over the Skyhawks. Called strike three. The batter will get caught looking, and Jake Lissette is out. So really, really huge pitch there from Cam as he manages to strike out the batter and regain some confidence here.
Not bad. Number 17, Braden Coffey.
Braden Coffey steps in, looking to score that runner from third. Cam gets the signal. Here's the pitch. Call the ball. Call time. Coach Tyler looking to walk up over to the mound. Coach Tyler returns to the dugout. Cam remains in the game after getting that talk from the coach. 1-0 count here. Strike one. Skyhawks do appear to have some new pitchers warming up in the bullpen. Cam Seibert delivers the next pitch, swung on, into play, caught by the third baseman, throws over to first, and that'll be out number two. The runner will not advance from third to home. The third baseman, Jason Dower, does a great job licking him back over to third before throwing to first.
Not bad. Number 42, Cam Trusclair.
Here's Cam Trusclair stepping into bat. Jason Dower does a great job making sure that advanced, that runner does not advance. First pitch, call the ball. Definitely looks like it could have been a strike. It'll be two outs, one man on third. Swung on, foul tips. And will leave the ball field, so will not be caught. Be 1-1 count here. Cam versus Cam. Ball two. In the dirt, but well collected by the catcher, preventing the runner from advancing from third. Skyhawks looking to prevent a runner from scoring. That ball will also be in the dirt, but collected well from Easton. And no advancement from the runner. Maybe a 3-1 count here with two outs. A walk here, I'd say, wouldn't be the end of the world. It'll not advance the runner. With two outs, it will be a walk here for the Crusaders. Ball gets away from Easton there, but he collects it well. It'll be Brady Wilson's turn to swing the bat. Catcher giving some signals here.
Number 16, Brady Wilson.
good communication here from the Skyhawks, knowing what to do with the ball. Should it get put in play? It'll be a runner on first and third with two outs. William Carey hoping to extend their lead. Here's the pitch, call ball. Second pitch will also be called a ball. An aggressive lead over there at first by Cam Trusclair. So he wins the battle of Cams, gets the walk. Cam Seiwert looking to shut the Crusaders down. That'll be his third straight ball. Starting this count off 3-0. Maybe I don't want to walk the bases loaded here. Don't want to give a pitch too easy to hit to allow the runners to score. Pitch to the plate, ball 4. It'll be bases loaded here with 2 outs. No movement out here from the dugout. It looks like it'll be Cam's batter to face. Cam Seiwert doing what he can to prevent any more runs from scoring here. Looks like we might have a pinch runner. Yes, we do. A pinch runner here for Cam Trusclair out there in second. Maybe number 28 for the Crusaders, Ty Little.
Pinch runner on second, number 28, Ty Little.
Base is loaded here. Putting some speed out there at second for the DH, Cam Trusclair. Cam Seiwert with his first pitch. Call the strike. See if Cam can get ahead of the count here early. Strike this batter out. Get the bats in the hands of the Skyhawks. Second pitch. Swung on. Shortstop cannot collect it. It'll be out into the left field. Runner rounds third and will score. Good choice there from the Crusaders to put some speed on the base. And it'll be 2 more runs given up by Cam. 2 outs. Man on first and second now. So Billy Garrity there, able to bring in 2 runners. 2 RBI single. First pitch is a call to ball. The ball was hit out there to the shortstop. And Sam couldn't quite collect it. Cam's next pitch will be swung on and fouled away. Maybe would have liked to see Sam get in front of the ball on that hit rather than trying to make a play just to prevent the ball from getting out into left field and preventing 2 runs from scoring and only allowing 1. Bradley Thomas here looking to continue to add on for William Carey. That ball is fouled through the legs of the catcher. It'll be a 1-2 count here. Cam Seiwert getting to a lot of 2-strike counts, but just cannot seem to put these batters away. He's earned himself some strikeouts, but could really use another one here. Cam will step off the rubber. Runners will return. steps back on the rubber. Looking to get a signal here from Easton. Gets the signal. Looks the runner's back. Comes with a pitch. Ooh, dangerous pitch there. Narrowly called strike three. But a good eye there from Ridley. Be a 2-2 count. Two outs. Next pitch, swung on, foul tips, just to the left of the plate. Ridley Thomas, looking to swing the bat here. Swings it, fouls it left. Gets some good protection swings here. Not willing to go down easily. Remains a 2-2 count. Cam Sy will step off the rubber once again here in this at-bat. Steps back on the rubber. Just needs one more strike. We'll get out of this inning. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed. Strike three. That'll be another strikeout there for Cam as he ends the bleeding and only allows two runners here in this inning. And we'll be back on the Sports Skyhawks Network. Entering the bottom of the fifth inning, stepping over to the plate is Easton Harrison, catcher here for the Skyhawks, looking to try and chip away at the 5-1 lead by the Crusaders. Bobby McGee out there, still pitching. Nobody out there in the Crusader bullpen. It's Bobby McGee's game here. Skyhawks down four runs. As the pitch is delivered. Ball. Two balls, one strike. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed. It'll be a 2-2 count here. Skyhawks will be facing the Crusaders in a doubleheader tomorrow at 1-4. The first conference games here by either team, as that pitch is high. Be a full count. Quite the battle here between the pitcher and the batter. Early on in this inning. That pitch called strike three. Harrison will be caught looking. He thought it was a ball. Umpire thought different.
Up the bat, your shortstop, number 11, Sal Baker!
Sam Baker off the bat here. Bobby McGee with the pitch. Swung on. Hit into the gap. And dove in, caught by the center fielder. Quite the play from Gerard. Sam McGee takes his helmet off and tips it to the center fielder.
Now batting number two, Silas Butler.
Sam's upset about that when you know it. But quite the play there from Gerard Williams. Running, covering the gap, dives for the ball, and makes the catch. It'll be Silas Butler here to lead off the batting order with two outs here for the Skyhawks. Bobby McGee with quite the grunt there on that pitch. It'll be a ball two. Once again, no pitchers in the bullpen here. The bottom of the fifth inning. Bobby McGee well in control of this game. Pitching very well with only one earned run so far. Through 4 2/3 innings of work. Silas takes ball 3 and strike 1. Looking to maybe get on base via the walk. Here's the pitch. Swung on, tipped away. Be a 2-2 count as that ball rolls all the way back to the catcher. Full count here with two outs. Silas Butler looking to get on base here. Swung. Strike 3. Oh, no, it's a ball 4. Ball 4. The ball gets away from the catcher. No strike call there from the umpire.
Now batting for his call, number 1, Kenny Jackson.
Kenny Jackson steps in. Bobby McGee definitely starting to grunt here as he pitches. Not sure if he's showing fatigue or if he's just trying to get a little bit of extra steam on these pitchers. First pitch there to Kenny Jackson is swung on and missed. Runner on first here with two outs. Pickoff move. Gets away from the first baseman. Silas Butler will advance to second. And he will also advance to third. Ball comes into the center field and back into the infield. That'll be an error committed once again by the Crusaders. So now there's a runner at third here. Swung on and missed. Two strikes, no balls, two outs. Skyhawks desperately looking to score that runner from third. Kenny Jackson fighting here in this at bat. Bobby McGee with quite the grunt on that pitch as well. It'll be a ball. Next pitch. Called strike 3. That'll end the inning for the Skyhawks. And that'll be it for this inning on the Skyhawks Sports Network. Entering to pitch now for your Skyhawks, number 24, Gene Aberett.
Number
Gene Abbott joins the Skyhawks from San Bruno, California. Right-handed pitcher. The first relief pitcher here for the Skyhawks. First relief pitcher of the game. As Cam's day is done. So Cam Seibert will end his pitching experience here in this game. Five total innings pitched, five runs given up, seven hits with one error committed during his pitching by the Skyhawks. Not the game I don't think Cam was looking for here against William Carey. But let's see what Gene can do for the Skyhawks. First pitch, just call the ball. Second pitch, swung on, tipped high into the air. Center fielder will call off the second baseman and make the catch. Good first out there by Gene.
Now batting, number 18, Gerard Williams.
Gerard Williams steps into bat here. One out here for the Crusaders. Righty-righty matchup. Swung on and missed. Good pitch there from Gene. Second pitch swung on. This one's tipped, but back behind the plate for a foul ball. Be a 2-2 count, or is an 0-2 count, excuse me. Two strikes, no balls. Rod Williams playing fantastic defense for the Crusaders. His next pitch will be fouled away once again. Makes a diving catch in the last inning. Stealing an extra base hit from Sam Baker. Next pitch, call the ball. 1-2 count. Skyhawks trying to quickly end the Crusaders' batting experience so they can get back up to bat. Bat does not go all the way around, so it'll be a called ball. 2-2 count. Strike three. Caught looking is Gerard Williams. Gene Abbott, two batters faced, two outs. That one via the strikeout. Back to the top of the batting order here for William Carey. RJ Stinson back up to bat. First pitch is called a ball. Be RJ Stinson's fourth bat appearance here in the sixth inning. Second pitch, this one's called a strike. 1-1 count. Gene Abbott looks really, really good out of the bullpen. Next pitch, swung on, foul tips, just outside the foul line. Be a 1-2 count. Gene Abbott looking for his second strikeout here against his third batter. That pitch will be high, call the ball. Next pitch, call the ball once again. Another high pitch. Two high pitches consecutively. Be a full count with two outs. Nobody on base right now. Battle here between the pitcher and the batter. Swung on. Put in play. Sam makes the catch at short. Throws it first. the batter will be out. That'll end the inning for the Crusaders. No runs given up this time. And great inning worth of pitching from Gene Abbott. And it'll be the Skyhawks' turn to bat next on the Skyhawks Sports Network. Stepping in the bat here is Slade Mink. Responsible for that home run in the last game, but he also stole a base. Maybe he can get on base here and be aggressive. First pitch, called a strike from Bobby McGee. He enters his sixth inning of work here, the bottom of the sixth inning. William Carey does have somebody in the bullpen warming up. Second pitch is called a strike again. Slade Mink down early in this count. That ball will be tipped foul. Well behind the plate. Definitely some movement over there in the William Carey bullpen. That pitch swung on, hit into center field. But an easy play there from Gerard Williams. Doesn't require him to dive on that one. Much more like the previous outside he's caught.
Now batting for the Skyhawks, number 13, Alex Marquand.
Only four hits here for the Skyhawks as Alex Marquand steps up to the plate. However, they do have a lot of contact today. A lot of balls put in the outfield too. I believe about 7 or 8 balls caught by the outfield today. First pitch here from Bobby McGee, well outside. Alex Marquand looking to get on base here for the Skyhawks. Takes that pitch. I'm going to say it again. Bobby McGee pitches very quickly. Alex Marquand steps in the box, and the pitch is almost coming his way right as he steps in. That ball will be a ball. The reason why I mention that is it almost looked like Alex wasn't even ready for that pitch when he stepped in the box. 2-1 count here for the Skyhawks. That'll be tipped. Foul ball. Two count. Bobby McGee looking to get his strikeout number up. That'll be a call the ball. Quite the game pitched here from Bobby McGee. But like I said, not too many strikeouts as the Skyhawks have put the ball in play. Just can't seem to find open field. That'll be swung on. Hit towards the second baseman. He makes the play. Throws it first. And that'll be an out for Alex Marquand. Crusaders will get their second out of the inning.
Off the bat for your Skyhawks, number 33, Zeb Baird.
Zeb Baird here steps in. Two outs. Skyhawks running out of outs slowly here. chip away at that lead from the Crusaders. First pitch swung on. Missed. Four strike. Not a pitch he wanted to swing at. Second pitch swung on once again. Swung on and missed once again. Two count, two strikes. Bobby McGee with the pitch. That'll be called a ball. Multiple Crusaders were running over to their dugouts. But it's called a ball. I believe Zeb might have even thought that was a strike because he started to head towards his dugout. That'll be hit through to the outfield for a base hit. Zeb takes advantage of the extra pitch and puts that ball in play. Ernie gets an extra at bat here.
Up the bat for his scholars, your second baseman, number 3, Mason Davis!
Mason Davis here. Looking to put some runs on the board. Foul tips it into the helmet of the catcher. Seems to be okay. Umpire gives us the courtesy of giving him some extra time by running out to the pitcher. Gotta love that from the umpire. So in that previous at-bat, with two strikes, a third pitch was thrown and no swing from Zeb. What looked to be a strike was called a ball and allowed the Skyhawks to get a base hit off that next pitch and keep the inning alive. Next pitch is called a ball. Down in the dirt, well collected by the catcher. Braden Coffey, the catcher for the Crusaders, definitely calling a good game here. Bobby McGee with only one earned run through 5 2/3 innings. Next pitch, that'll be called a ball outside once again. 6 2/3 innings, my mistake. No, 5 2/3, yes. 5 2/3. Next pitch, swung on and missed. Strike two. Two count. Swung on, foul tipped back behind the plate. Zeb Barrett over there at first base. Mason up to bat. Next pitch, swung on. Tipped back behind the plate once again. Doing whatever he can to put contact on the ball to keep this at bat alive. It remained a 2-2 count with two outs. Swung on. Fouled off again behind the plate. Mason in defense mode here. Quite the battle here. Bobby McGee looks in. Delivers the pitch. Swung on. Put it in play this time. The shortstop makes the play. Throws it to first. And collects the outs. That'll be the third out for the Skyhawks as they go down here in the sixth inning with no runs to count for. We'll be back here for the Skyhawk Sports Network. Jake Lissette steps up to bat here, facing off against Gene Aberrett for his second inning of work. First pitch will be called a ball. Gene Aberrett with a fantastic first inning of work as he puts down three batters, one via the strikeout. That'll be hit towards the second baseman. Collects it well. Does it first. One out. Quick out there for Gene. Jake Lissette goes down without too much noise from the bat. Here comes the catcher, Braden Coffey. As previously mentioned, he has called a very good game to help out his pitcher, Bobby McGee. Shutting down the Skyhawks, who in eight total, that pitch will hit the batter and earn Braden a free base. So the first mistake here by Gene Aberrett. Third base coach looking to talk to the umpire about something here. It'll be a pinch runner. So the catcher will be pinch ran for.
Up to bat, number five, Preston Rettler.
Looks like we have a pinch hitter here as well. Not a pinch hitter, I believe, because the DH got pinch ran for in the last inning. It's Preston Ratliff off the bat. He swings at the first pitch. First throw to second. Thrown to first. Well collected by the first baseman. That'll be a double play, and Gene Aberrett will get through three batters and face the minimum. What a play there by the Skyhawks. And we'll be back here on the Skyhawks Sports Network.
Number 21, Jason Dower.
Jason Dower here steps up first for the Skyhawks in the bottom of the seventh inning. Bobby McGee out to pitch once again. Going deep into this game for the Crusaders. Shutting down the Skyhawks' bats. Not allowing more than five hits here through six innings of work. First pitch will be high for a ball. What a finish off to that top of the seventh inning there for the Skyhawks with a runner on first via the hit by pitch. Looks like we got a communication device malfunction. Catcher gets a new one here from the pitching coach, I would assume. But with a runner on first, the Crusaders hit the ball to the third baseman. Throws it to the second baseman, who then completes the play over to first for a double play to end the inning for the Crusaders. Back up to bat is Jason Dowers. Here's the pitch from Bobby. Well outside for ball two. That ball will be fouled off into the stands. Jason Dower here with the pitch. Swung on and missed. 2-2 count. Next pitch. Called ball three. Bobby McGee wanted that pitch, but just barely high above the plate. Be a full count here for Jason. Next pitch will be in on him and hit the batter. Jason Dower seems to be okay as he jogs over to first. Bobby McGee with a bit of a mistake there. So he hits the batter. Looks like we got a pinch hitter here. Got a pinch hitter here for the Skyhawks, Chris Mansell. Coming in to bat for Easton Harrison. First pitch he sees will be a ball. Skyhawks looking to infuse a new bat here. With the man on first. Catcher will approach Bobby McGee as the head coach for the Crusaders will approach the pitcher. Looks like two Crusaders out there in the bullpen. So as the Crusader coach heads back to the dugout, Bobby McGee will remain the pitcher for the Crusaders. You got two Crusaders out there in the bullpen. Looks like two right-handed pitchers. Bobby McGee here with a 1-0 count. Next pitch. Swing on. Hit and will drop into the left field. There's a base hit right there for the Skyhawks as they will have batters at runners out first and second here for Sam Baker.
Up the bat, number 11, Sam Baker.
We also got a pinch runner here. Number 4.
Pinch runner first. Number 4,
Hunter Neumeier. Hunter Neumeier. Be his second pinch running attempt here, I believe. Sam Baker got robbed of a base hit. Probably an extra base hit out there in center by Gerard Williams. Hoping to get on base here. Be a crucial inning here for the Skyhawks. Bobby McGee will step off the rubber. It is still his inning here. As now the coach comes back out of the dugouts. Maybe looking to pull Bobby here. And that looks like that'll be the game for Bobby McGee. Quite the game pitched by him. Gotta give him credit. Makes it through six complete innings of work. So six complete innings of work. He will be responsible for the runners at first and second. And we'll be back here on the Skyhawk Sports Network. The new pitcher for the William Carey Crusaders will be Luke Lissette, number 2, right-handed pitcher here. Up to bat. So Bobby McGee with 6 complete innings of work. Only 1 run given up so far. He is responsible for the runners at first and second. Gave up 6 hits with 2 errors committed during his pitching. Sam Baker is still up to bat. Here's the first pitch from Lissette. Shows bunt, does Sam Baker, pulls it back quickly as that ball was well outside the plate. Sam Baker maybe trying to get the runners over to second and third with nobody out here. Potential dangerous inning here for the Skyhawks. Hopefully looking to get some runs to chip away at that lead. Second pitch. Shows bunt. Called strike. Pitch looks pretty outside, but got enough of the plate to be called a strike. So this will be bunted. Thrown to third. Over to first. Will not be thrown to first. So Sam Baker with the bunt there. Bunts it straight back to the pitcher who collects it well. Keeps his composure. Throws it to third. Gets the force out at third. Silas Butler here. With 1 out. It'll remain runners at first to second. With 1 out here for Silas. First pitch gets away from the catcher. Runners advance for second and third. Everybody's safe, and they will remain at second and third. Luke Lissette with a wild pitch there. First pitch to really get by the catcher. Braden Coffey doing a well done job there at the catching position. Keeping everything in front of him. But that ball well inside the other batter box gets away from him there. Here's the pitch. Will be ball. Gets away from him again. Runner's running home. He flicks it home. Safe will be the runner. Good job from the catcher. The ball didn't get too far away from him, so he flicks the ball to the pitcher who's covering now at the plate. But with a bit of a high throw and a quick run there from 4, he'll be safe. So, runner will advance from second to third as well. It'll be 1 out. Next pitch is low, ball 3. 3 balls, no strikes. Hunter Neumeier, the pinch runner there, does a great job being aggressive and not hesitating once that ball got past the catcher. And he'll get a run for it. That next pitch will be called ball 4. Silas will get a free base here. And Kenny Jackson will step up to the plate with runners in first and third.
Number 1, Kenny Jackson!
With only 1 out. It's 5-2. William Carey leads the game. But the Skyhawks, already with 1 run here in this inning. Now that we got Bobby McGee off the mound, we might be able to see if we can get some bats going. Already chipping away at this lead. Can we drill a real big hole? Here's the pitch. Called strike 1. Dominant game here from Bobby McGee. He will be responsible for that run that was scored, so he'll give up 2 runs so far in this game. Still responsible for the runner at third. Only 1 out. Called ball 1. You got an aggressive lead from Silas Butler over there at first. You could see him still second and see if that runner from third can get home. Skyhawks, well known for doing that. That'll be ball in the dirt. Another really aggressive lead and another really aggressive secondary lead from Silas Butler over there at first. The Skyhawks are looking to get runs any way they can late in this game. Next pitch, ball. Once again, ball 3 from Jake, from Luke Lissette. Jake Lissette, likely his brother over there at first. Got them mixed up. That ball will be foul tipped behind the plates. It'll be a full count here for Kenny Jackson. Looks like the Crusaders do have one man warming up in the bullpen, a right-handed pitcher. Appears to be fully warming up, so he is going to be ready to come in most likely whenever it's needed. Here's the pitch. Called strike three. Kenny Jackson will take that third strike. Looking for ball four there to earn that free base, and it'll be two outs here for the Skyhawks.
Up to bat for the Skyhawks is number eight, Slay Me.
Here's stepping in Slade Meek. First pitch to him, swings at it. Bit of a half swing there, not a whole lot of power behind that swing. I think he saw that it was going to be a ball and just kind of too late to pull back for him there. Runners at first and third with two outs. Luke Lissette looking to shut this game down. That ball will be well inside. An off-speed pitch allows him to slide away from Slade as it almost hits him. But likely a slider or a curve there. Able to prevent it from hitting him. 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Put in play to the shortstop. Throws it over to first for the out, and that'll end the inning for the Skyhawks. So Skyhawks do manage to score a run to chip the lead down to 5-2. The Crusaders will continue to lead, and we'll be back here on the Skyhawks Sports Network. Entering the top of the eighth inning here, we have a new catcher for the Skyhawks. It'll be Chris Mansell. Gene Averett still out there on the mound. Two really good innings of work from Gene as he faces the minimum after hitting that first batter. First pitch here from Gene will be a ball. So the second batter he faces in that inning, he hits with a pitch, but that next batter will hit himself into a double play. Next pitch, inside, ball two. Top of the eighth inning here. Only two more attempts to swing the bats for the Skyhawks. That'll be a strike right there as he swings and misses. Six outs remain for the Skyhawks. They need three more runs to tie this ball game up. Next pitch. Easily a called strike. 2-2 count. Tonight's ball game will be a full 90-inning game, but the ball games tomorrow will be 7 innings. Doubleheader here between William Carey and the Point University Skyhawks. Next pitch swung on, foul tipped behind the plate. Remains a 2-2 count. Here's the pitch from Gene. Inside, ball three. Full count here, the first bat of the inning. Skyhawks looking to prevent any more runs from scoring. They want a chance to come back in this game. Swung on and missed, strike three. Gene Averett gets his next strikeout victim. Brady Wilson. Gene Averett pitching quite the game here in relief for Cam Seiwert. Doing his best to keep the Skyhawks in this game. Here's Billy Garrity here for the Crusaders. Shows bunt. It'll be a ball one. Gets away from the catcher there, but nobody on base, so not too big of a deal. Next pitch will be a called strike, 1-1 count. Next pitch will be a ball called inside. Ball three. 3-1 count here. Nobody on base with one out. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed. It'll be strike two. Full count here. That ball will be hit high. Second baseman retreats into the outfield. Gets called off by the center fielder, who does make the catch. Great communication there from the Skyhawks. That ball was pretty deep out there in center field. Closer to right field, but the center fielder able to come in as Slade makes the catch. Not Slade, Silas. Up to bat here, Bradley Thomas for the Crusaders. Looking to hit a two-out rally here. Shows bunt. Looks like that hit off the face mask of either the catcher or the umpire. As it gets behind the catcher, but once again, nobody on base, so doesn't allow anybody to advance. Doesn't show bunt there. Hits it high, deep in the center field. The center fielder retreats on the warning track, makes the catch. A dangerous hit there from the Crusaders, Bradley Thomas. And that'll be it for the Skyhawks on the Skyhawk Sports Network. Stepping up to the plate here in the bottom of the eighth inning, Alex Marquand. During the intermission, when the pitcher throws his warm-up pitches to the catcher will always end the inning throwing the ball to second base to practice catching runners stealing second. as that ball is called a strike. And a quick comment there for the catcher of the Crusaders, Braden Coffey. He has thrown the ball to second baseman on a dime every single warm-up. Second pitch will be inside, called a ball. So, based off my opinion, Braden Coffey, quite the catcher when throwing the second, the catch runner stealing. Perhaps that's why we haven't seen any stolen bases here by the Skyhawks. Luke Lissette back out to pitch here in the second inning of relief. That'll be called strike. 1-2 count here for Alex Marquand. Luke Lissette has given up a run, or excuse me, has given up a hit, but the run was not responsible for him, as that ball will be in the dirt for a called ball. Alex Marquand trying to get the bats going here for the Skyhawks. DHing in today's game. Can typically seen at first base as he swings, puts it in play. Easy play for the shortstop, but he bobbles it, throws it to first, and the first baseman drops the ball. Gets by him, but Alex Marquand will not advance to second. Zeb Baird will step in to take his next at bat. Not a very clean transaction there by the Crusader defense. A very routine ground ball to the shortstop, who bobbles the ball once again, throws it over to first, and the first baseman can't make the catch. First pitch is called a ball. That will allow Alex Marquand to be sitting at first over there with nobody out. Five to two ball game, William Carey leads. Second pitch will be swung on by Zed, swung on and missed. Crowd starting to get back into this game, trying to cheer on their Skyhawks. Next pitch, swung on and missed once again. Aggressive lead out there by Alex Marquand. One, two count here. Strike three called. Off-speed pitch starts outside the zone and creeps in. A little bit of strikeout there for Luke Lissette.
Now batting for Wisconsin, number three, Mason Davis.
Mason Davis stepping in here with one out, one on. First pitch. He appeals to first, and he says he went. Does the umpire. Definitely a close call there. Not sure if he went from my angle. But the first base umpire says he does. Maybe one strike. Called strike is the second pitch. Two quick strikes there from Luke Lissette. Next pitch, swung on. Has to swing at that one based off those previous called strikes. It'll be caught by the right fielder. Easy fly out there. It'll be two outs here with one on.
Up the bat for Scott is number 21, Jason Dower.
With one out here left in the bottom of the eighth inning, Jason Dower will step into plate looking to put some more points on the board for Skyhawks. Desperately need runs here. First pitch, high, ball one. Next pitch will be called a strike. Lots of off-speed pitches here from Luke Lissette. Starting off the plate and creeping in. Next pitch, that'll be a fastball. Collected on the dirt. Batter does not go around. It'll be a ball. Skyhawks can slow their bats down and connect on those off-speed pitches. They appear to be in the center of the plate. 2-1 count, two outs. Called ball three. Jason Dower here can earn himself a walk. It'll put the tying run at the plate here for the Skyhawks with two outs. Call strike two. He sat and ate that pitch. Watched it go by. Looking like he is trying to earn a walk, maybe. Runner steals. It'll be a ball four. And that will bring up the tying run to the plate. Number seven. Chris Mansell coming up to bat here.
Up to bat for the Skyhawks is number seven, Chris Mansell.
Runners on first and second. The tying run at the plate for the Skyhawks, but there are two outs. Luke Lissette remains the pitcher here. There is some activity over there in the bullpen for the Crusaders, as that got Alex Marquand at first, or at second. Jason Dower at first. Swung on and missed. Chris with a good swing there. Doesn't connect on the ball, however. With a full count with two outs, the runners will have Mance did that in the previous at bat. Smart base running. 2-1 count here. Next pitch, swung on and missed. It'll be a 2-2 count with two outs here. Skyhawks clinging to everything they can. Can Luke Lissette put the Skyhawks away? Next pitch, swung on. Hit deep into the center field. Center fielder sits under the ball and makes the catch, ending the inning for the Skyhawks with two runners left on base. And we'll be right back after this break for the Skyhawks Sports Network. New pitcher here for the Skyhawks. Number five, Sage McWaters, coming in from Panama City, Florida. Sage McWaters, a super senior here. Sage is the typical closer for the Skyhawks, performing the closer role here today as well. up to bat here for the Crusaders. Number 10, Rigoberto Hernandez. First batter to face Sage McWaters. Sage's first pitch, called a ball just above the plate. His next pitch, that'll be a strike. There we go. Bit of a poor throw back to the pitcher, but he managed to catch it. Here's his next pitch, swung on. Looks like it was fouled off by the batter. Be a 1-2 count. Sage McWaters, closer for the Skyhawks today. Next pitch will be called a ball. In Sage's previous action, he has two outs. That ball's hit hard in the right field and caught by the right fielder. No, yes, caught by the right fielder. Nice little diving play from him. Good catch there from Kenny Jackson. As I was saying, Sage's McWaters' last bit of action, he managed to get two outs. He did have runs scored on him, but he was not responsible for those runs. We got a new batter here for the Crusaders. Stepping in for Gerard Williams will be Chris Jones, number 6. That'll be a strike one. Good pitch there from Sage. Coming off the bench, Chris will take that first pitch. Maybe looking to see what Sage has to offer. Here's the pitch from Sage. Called strike two. Good pitch there. That's an off-speed one right there. Switching it up on Chris, making sure you can't see exactly what Sage has to offer. Coming off the bench, you can assume that's just very hard for baseball players to do. Not seeing any pitches and then being thrown in the ninth inning. That'll be called ball. Coaches have a lot of faith in their pinch hitters to throw them in there at the very end of the game and expect something out of them. Sage quickly pitching here. Be a ball. 2-2 count here. One out, nobody on. Next pitch from Sage. Called strike three. Chris Jones will strike out looking. First strike out there from Sage McWaters. It'll be back to the top of the lineup here for the William Carey Crusaders.
Now batting left fielder, number 12, R.J. Stinson.
R.J. Stinson back up to bat here. Performing well so far for the Crusaders, has he? Sage Waters trying to keep the Crusaders up to 5 total runs here. As his first pitch to RJ will be a strike. Second pitch will be just called a ball, just off the plate outside. Sage Waters quickly pitching, getting that ball, getting that signal, and throwing to the plate. His next pitch swung on, hit to the shortstop, and caught on the fly. That'll be it for the Crusaders. 1 half inning left to play here. And we're going to take a break here on the Skyhawk Sports Network. Up to bat now here for your Skyhawks in their final attempt to get back into this game. Sam Baker. Got a new pitcher here as well for the Crusaders. Number 9, John Snyder. Did the batter swing? Yes, he did. Sam Baker did go around for strike one. John Snyder performing the closing role today for the Crusaders as he pitches. Called strike two, well framed by the catcher. Sam Baker down early here in this at-bat. Two strikes to no balls. Bottom of the ninth inning here. Strike three, swung on and missed. Sam Baker will go down swinging. One out, only two outs left for the Skyhawks.
Out the bat for his Dawson's number two, Silas Butler.
Silas Butler here. Gotta get on base. Only two outs remaining for the Skyhawks. Here's John Snyder. Called strike well off the plate. Not getting any luck here as the Skyhawks as that's called a strike. Good frame job there by the catcher though. Strike two as he swung on and missed. Siler quickly down two strikes. Steps out the box, steps back in. Here's the pitch. Virtually the same pitch. This time it's called a ball. The Crusaders looking to extend their win streak to 4 games and prevent the Skyhawks from earning their own win streak up to 2. Next pitch swung on and missed. Silas will go down swinging. John Snyder comes in, strikes out the first two batters he sees in that closing performance role.
Now batter Chris Johnson, number one, Kenny Jackson.
John Snyder, can he get an immaculate inning as he has 7 straight strikes and 2 strikeouts? We could see an immaculate inning here by the closer, John Snyder. It's quite the achievement if he were to get one here. Swung on and missed. One pitch away from an immaculate inning from John Snyder. Two strikes. Swung on. Hit into the field of play. Popped up. Snyder, you can see how upset he is. Oh, and he drops it! And the runner will advance to second. So Skyhawks have life here with 2 outs. Slade Mink looking to give the Skyhawks an at-bat right here. So John Snyder, one pitch away from an immaculate inning. Kenny Jackson able to tip it into the air, and it's dropped by the second baseman. And John Snyder, you can just see the frustration on his face that he didn't quite get that immaculate inning. Here's the pitch here. Called strike one. John Snyder, quite the pitcher. Throwing absolute heat tonight. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Put in play. Over to the first baseman. He drops the ball. Can't find the ball. And safe will be the runner. The Skyhawks have life. The tying run will be at the plate here. It's Alex Marquand. One of the Skyhawks' best hitters. And a clutch at-bat performance right here. John Snyder doing everything he can to shut the Skyhawks down. But 2 consecutive errors likely by the Crusaders. Alex Marquand, the tying run at the plate. Can he hit a home run like he did 2 games ago? Here's the pitch. Ball one. John Snyder starting to grunt himself, trying to do everything he can to end this game and send the Crusaders home with a win here tonight. Runners on first and third. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Missed by Alex. That was quite the hack there from Alex. You can see he's trying to go yard maybe. Marquand steps back into the box. Here's the pitch. Well outside. 2-1 count, two outs. You can hear the fans. You can hear the Skyhawks cheering on their team, desperately looking for some runs here in the bottom of the ninth. Here's the pitch, swung on, fouled behind the plates. Can the catcher make a play? No, that ball is well outside the fence. 2-2 count here with two outs, bottom of the ninth. Tying run at the plates. Can Marquand make magic happen? Marquand steps back in the box. The fans are rowdy. Here's the pitch. Foul back once again. Staying alive is Marquand. We'd like to see him get on base here, but you know he's trying to put the ball in play and make magic happen himself. Only the tying run at the plate here, so he's got to hit the ball out of the park in order to tie it up himself. But like I said, he hit a home run two games ago. I know he's got the power. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Put in play. Dribbler up to the second shortstop. Throws it to first. And he is out of there. That'll be the ball game there, folks. William Carey does defeat the Skyhawks 5-2. Thank you all for joining me. And a reminder that there is a game, two games tomorrow at 1 o'clock and 4 o'clock. Once again, from Willie Carey versus Skyhawks as William Carey defeats the Skyhawks 5-2. See you all tomorrow.